For more than 20 years, Eddie Seward has monitored the magic on Wimbledon's centre court, watching both the cut and thrust of the game and the cut and dust of the surface beneath the players' feet. He's seen champions come and go, but before he contemplates his own retirement this year, Eddie faces the toughest challenge of his career as Wimbledon's head groundsman.
Well, this year is different because of the Olympics, with the Olympics only being about 10 days after the championships. So we've got very little time in which to prepare the courts.
Eddie's team is making sure the All England Tennis Club is ready for the ultimate workout, hosting two high-profile tournaments within just a month of each other. They must stick to a strict routine, cutting the grass to an exact 8 millimetres for optimum play and keeping an eye on ground temperature and humidity.
When I first started here, where the players used to serve and run in and wait to receive the return of ball, and they used to check and stop and wear the grass out. There's a patch in the middle there. And that slowly but surely moved further back every year until it's disappeared completely.
This is what they're hoping to avoid. Heavily worn courts with barren patches almost devoid of grass. So the ground staff have brought in extra help.
Here we've got a little hole in centre court. And it's quite an important hole for me, this. It allows me to measure how much moisture there is at different depths through the root zone of the court. There must be several million grass plants out there, and I've picked on three of them because it's the wrong grass. It's a big disaster in the making, is this. If this grass comes to the fore, we're going to have a very spongy soft surface, which is the last thing we want.
The perfect Wimbledon lawns aren't the result of work just in London, but also hundreds of kilometres away in the north of England, where a mini Wimbledon has been created.
Just behind me is our Wimbledon grass testing area, a little bit of SW19 in West Yorkshire. And here we've got the Wimbledon soil, and we can test the grasses that they may use in the future here. So we can whittle them down, we can get rid of the chaff and hopefully keep the wheat for them.
Some of Britain's most iconic sporting surfaces have been through their paces at this institute in Yorkshire. The golfing fairways of St Andrews, the cricket wicket of Lord's, Wembley Stadium soccer pitch and the racing royalty of Ascot.
One of the problems here is that we can't actually get tennis players to run around on our plots systematically. So what we have is a wear machine, which means that we can put the same amount of wear on each plot and each little area of grass.
From a purely scientific point of view, the perfect player to minimise wear and tear would be a lightweight serve and volley specialist rather than a bruising baseline battler. More Gilles Simon than Joe Wilfried Tsonga, perhaps. While the world's best tennis players battle over their Wimbledon dream, the grass court king Eddie Seward will be keeping his feet and his gaze firmly on the ground.